everyone, welcome to my channel. I'm Hilda. Today I'm going to show you 5 DIY planters with items which are of no use to me. 4 will be planters and 1 will be a pot. So let's get started.
For the first DIY, I'm going to use this bouquet stand which we generally throw. I'm going to use this yogurt container as a planter. This or a smaller one, whichever one. I want to spray paint these. But before I get into spray painting, I just want to make a little heart here with molding clay. I'm using Fevicryl molded clay. It has a hardener and a resin. Mix both well till it becomes of one color. Use talcum powder and roll with a rolling pin. I'm using a cookie cutter here to cut the heart shape. Click on the eye button above to see how to make a heart without using a cookie cutter. So now I let these dry and then I'm going to spray paint. I'm using a yellow spray paint first, and while it's wet, I'll use orange spray paint on it to give an ombre effect. I'll use the orange spray paint from a little distance. Using a black acrylic slightly to give a distressed look. Now the paint is absolutely dry and I'm going to use this varnish to seal the paint. Now the second one is my favorite one. This is a grater and I have 2 of these, so I plan to turn this into a planter. So the first way is that we just leave it as it is. We put a plant in this, a pot in this, like this. And to hang, we can use this point, the center point. So the second way is that we color it. I'm going to use a coat of black gesso, homemade black gesso. You can click on the eye button to see how I made this.
Remove the excess paint and color slightly all over.
It's giving this very old, rusted look, which I quite like.
Once the paint is absolutely dry, we will use the matte varnish to seal the paint.
For the third one, I'm using this teapot. My house help broke the lid. And I was very happy because I didn't like this teapot, and I'm very happy that I can turn it into a planter now. I'm going to use acrylic paint for this. I'll keep it simple yet rustic.
Use brush wherever required. We will give a second coat once the first coat is absolutely dry. Using yellow acrylic while the orange color is wet, and using the same orange dabber. Now using brown acrylic with a different dabber, and then blending all over with the same orange dabber.
The paint is absolutely dry now. Now we can leave it at this stage, or we can further distress it by giving little stains of brown paint.
Using little water in brown acrylic and then using a soft brush to spray color all over.
So now we can leave it like this, or we can use jute twine, little bit here and little bit on the handle. So once the paint is absolutely dry, then I'm going to use this matte varnish to seal the paint. For the fourth one, I'm using this milk container. This is not in use anymore. For this, I'll be using chalk paint. I'll be using white at the base, and then blue on top, and then I'll give it a distressed look.
To see how to make chalk paint, click on the I button above. Using the blue chalk paint once the white chalk paint is absolutely dry.
Now the paint is absolutely dry and I'm going to use this sandpaper 150 to distress this. Now I plan to put this jute fabric here, and I found this image on Google. I just took a printout and I tore the edges, and I plan to put this here.
I am distressing the corners with the ink pad. I am using Fevicryl Mod Podge Decoupage Glue. If you don't have this, you can mix Fevicol and water in equal portions, and that's how you get decoupage glue. Using decoupage glue all over. Using jute twine on the handle. Cut the threads for a neat finish.
Once the paint is absolutely dry, then I'm going to use this matte varnish to seal the paint. For the fifth DIY, I'm going to use this funnel, but this I'm going to use as a pot. I'm going to put the plant inside this. I'm just going to wrap jute twine all around this.
If you wish to buy anything online with Itsy Bitsy, you can use my coupon code HILDA5 in caps. You will get an extra 5% discount. Link and coupon code mentioned in the description box below.
I plan to keep it simple like this, and I'll put a plant which will fall downwards like this.
For a lightweight potting mix, use 40% garden soil, 40% coco peat and 20% compost. You can use artificial flowers in the grater. It's going to look absolutely lovely. And even in the teapot.
So this is what I wanted to show you today. I hope you enjoyed my video. Do like, share, subscribe, and do let me know in the comment box below which one you like the most. I'll come back with another interesting video. Till then, bye bye, take care, and I love you all.